your signals, you are supposed to process these signals. First, you understand what kind of signals we're dealing with. We're dealing with the acceleration signals. These signals are both continuous and non-stationary. We say non-stationary means that the spectral content changes over time, and we want to detect the high frequency when the change, the sudden change that happens when the body of the person is impacting the ground. First of all, the conventional polytransform doesn't work here, so because it just gives you spectral information about the signal. It assumes that, like, if the frequencies are spread all over the signal, which is not the case in our signal, and it's fast based on sinusoidals. And it doesn't give you, of course, no temporal information, not be able to know where the frequencies in time are located. So we need a time frequency method that gives both time and frequency. What they found is the short time Fourier transform, just like Fourier transform, deals with the signal as chunks, so it takes the chunks of the signal and does the Fourier transform on each of these using a fixed moving window. So there is like a window and it moves all over the signal in order to take these chunks and just find the Fourier transform of each. So we're now using this diagram, the spectrogram, to find where they are located. This is good, but there is a problem here that the window width plays a big role. If you use a large window, you're going to get all the low frequencies, but you're not going to get the accurate time localization. But when you use a smaller window, you will get better time localization because you know exactly in which part your signal came from. And the basis are limited just sinusoidals. So when using the wavelet transform, use wavelets. The wavelets are based on the mother wavelet, so we can take the mother wavelet and either delay it or compress the wavelet in order to get an infinite number of possibilities. These vary in symmetry and smoothness, so for different signals or application you have, you could find a wavelet that's suitable. And it has compact support, means that it's finite in time, not unlike sinusoidals, so you're able to get better time localization here. We'll explain the feedback bank theory. This is what discrete wavelet does. It basically passes your signal through low pass and high pass filters in order to get the approximation and coefficients. So when you're passing through high pass filter, you get high frequency coefficients, which are the approximate details. And we use low pass filter, you're getting the approximation. The approximation are further decomposed into as many levels as you can have, which is limited by this equation. So it depends on the number of samples you have. This is some of the DWT families. We have the Haar and Dobichies and Beer-Thorner. The Haar is usually just very symmetric, and this is usually explained for students because the simplest form just does the averaging and differencing process. And the Dobichies are highly asymmetric, and this is an example for DB4, where 4 refers to the number of the elements in the filter. And also Beer-Thorner, this is unique because you can have different number of elements in each filter bank. For example, you have here in the low pass filter, you have 2 elements, and the high pass filter, you have 4 elements. The good thing we're applying first, we're acquiring acceleration, the x, y, z. We're finding details for each, and we're using just resultant acceleration to get this value. We apply a predefined threshold, which is chosen based on matrices that we have used, which will be explained by my colleague Wissam later on. And then we use an odd wavelet answer to measure the strength of the fault. And this information is actually included in the email, so we're able to know if the fault is strong or weak. After that, we go also at the same time in parallel, we're doing time domain analysis. We're just taking the signals and applying resultant acceleration, and we're using fusion techniques, so we're making contribution of both types of analysis in order to make a final decision on the status of the person. This example of a front fall, this is the time domain, the signal, the time domain, and this is the wavelet domain where you have a distinguishable peak, and you're able to know where it happened in time. Of course, I have to say that this is using Beer-Thorner 5.5 level 2, which was found after the evaluation, which we'll be explaining. This is a lab view implementation. We use just signal analysis toolkit from National Instruments to do this. So we're separating the details here and doing the resultant and result for time domain and the fusion. And here, we're comparing it to a specific threshold in order to find the strength of the form.